Thank you for tuning in to this Yin Yoga video and in celebration of March and spring coming. I thought we would focus on kind of clearing the old, welcoming the new, what that means for poses. It means doing some twisting poses that can detox, as well as poses that work in to kind of compress and open the core a little bit so that we can create that space. For props, you want a variety of things to sit on. So something that's kind of high lifted, like a bolster, or maybe a low bench or some pillows to sit on, a folded blanket, and some yoga blocks. If you don't have yoga blocks, a dictionary, encyclopedia could be a great little lift too. And we're gonna get started in a cross leg pose. And so I'm gonna sit on the bolster so that I'm really high. And then I have a nice comfy blanket that I can rest my shins. And then I'm really not focusing so much on the lower body here. So I've created a really comfortable seating position. So if this isn't comfortable for you, do some other seated pose, even sit in a chair if you'd like. And what we're gonna do is just do a little work into the upper body and the neck to shake off some of the tension for the day. So what we'll do is we'll take the right arm out with the thumb down, and then the back of the hand will come to the lower back. Just before you even let the head go, let that shoulder relax, let the arm relax down, take a deep breath in, deep breath out, and then let the left ear drop to the left shoulder. And just start to breathe naturally, but be aware of your breath, keeping your mind there so that we're taking nice, full, meaningful breaths. Focusing on the breath, letting go of the thoughts is clearing the mind. Creating that space for what's to come opposed to what's plaguing us now. Now as you breathe, I want you to imagine that you can breathe all the way up your arm, through your neck, into your jaw, on the side of your temple. As you inhale, imagine it's just filling up. Then softening on your exhale, maybe you can let your head go a little further. And do that once more. And then we'll release the right arm. And the head can come up, and we'll do that to the other side. The left arm will come out. Thumb down. Back of hand to lower back. Soften, prepare to get breath in. Out. Right ear to right shoulder. I count my breath in. I count my breath out. Counting can be a really nice way to bring the mind back to neutral if we've had a really mentally exhausting day and the brain's having trouble slowing down. Try those nice ballooning breaths where you breathe into your left arm, left neck, left side jaw and temple. And then go ahead, release. We'll take some shoulder rolls, marrying it with our breath. Inhale, we shrug up. You might even feel tension in your neck and your shoulders as you do that. And then release on the exhale and let the shoulders drop back and down. Inhale up, feel that tension, feel it vibrating. Exhale, let it go. One more time. And then we switch directions. And even if you still feel the tension, it's just nice to say to yourself, to say out loud, I'm letting go. I'm committing to it. Okay, so now we're gonna move into hero's pose. So I'm gonna change my seating orientation so that I'm kneeling on something soft and something's coming between my seat. But maybe not necessarily. If you sit right back on your heels with your toes untucked and that feels very relaxing and grounding for you, go for it. If not, you might benefit from a block under your seat, maybe two. You could even kind of put the small edge of the bolster between the legs. And my knees are bent. It's a little bit dark, right? Sorry about that. And then our hands are going to go ahead and reach for our knees, which is probably a slightly different posture than we take when we're seating in this pose when our hands are back a little bit more. So you might feel yourself pitching forward just a little bit. That's okay. Feel the ribs kind of pulling into the body. Feel the belly button pulling to the spine. As you round the spine just slightly and let the chin drop to the chest. Just breathe into your back body for a few rounds here. And then we'll let the head come up. We'll let the heart reach forward. Continue pulling on the knees, almost like you're trying to pull your chest towards the wall in front of you. And the chin might lift slightly from the chest, but keep it easy on the back of the neck. And then we'll go back to our cow. Ribs pull in, core pulls in, slowly bringing the neck to hang as the chest and the chin connect. And slowly making our way back through neutral and then reaching the heart forward, giving a little pull on the knees, lifting the chin slightly. All right, and then we can release that. We're gonna change our seat one more time. Seated postures really do target the core, because that's the area of the body keeping our torso perpendicular upright. That and some openness and flexibility in the hips. So you don't want to feel like it's a big core workout. And if you drop down to a blanket and you feel like you're working too much, have your seat up a little bit higher. You can also have a strategy of leaning your back into something, maybe the couch or the wall. And leaning is really a bad word for it, because you'd want the back of your seat kind of touching, so the prop behind you is helping to keep you upright. Have your strap handy. If you don't have a strap, no worries, we'll get by. And then both legs are gonna extend out straight. I'm sitting on that blanket, but if you feel yourself rocking back, sit on something higher, use the wall or couch support. And then our right knee is gonna bend. We're gonna get that foot close to our seat, and then we're gonna hold on for dear life, but really not. If it's feeling strenuous, like you're holding on for dear life, lift the seat higher, and you can interlace your hands, fingers, opposite hand to opposite wrist, whatever feels comfortable. And there's a little rounding in the spine here, and that's okay, that's purposeful. So as long as your back feels okay, that means we're working the spine in a healthy way. If you need a little bit more support, you could also put the strap around you and kind of choke up on the buckle so that it wraps around your upper back and also just below your knee. This will help kind of keep you in position, but try not to lean back like you're in a recliner. So if you're using the strap, make sure you continue to hold on to your leg. Here we go with that compression of our internal organs. Hopefully, if you're getting the leg close enough, if there's space, you could put a ball there or a pillow there so that you feel something pressing into that right side, front side, right side body. And you really want to soften in you. So one of the things that you can do, one of your homework while we're in the pose and while there's downtime, is to recognize when the thoughts turn back on, when we're filling our mind, and interrupt the thoughts by focusing on something here and the now, the breath, which will always help you kind of intensify the positive effects of the pose. Maybe something you're feeling in the body where there's tension that you can let go of, or there's tension that you can't let go of, and just acknowledging it. We're going to extend our right leg. We're not going to extend our right leg. We're going to let our right knee fall out to the right now. So I've set my strap aside and my right leg is going to wing out. I'm going to take a prop, probably a block, place it underneath the left knee so that leg is bending a little bit. Sorry, it's really hard to see. And then the torso is going to angle towards that extended leg. And we're going to flex at the hips. So you should feel that, you know, your lower abdomen is becoming closer to your thigh. And we're also gonna flex the spine or around the spine, and you can let the head go. I have my right arm reaching over for my left leg, which helps me square my shoulders. Sometimes the right arm or right shoulder is kind of pulling back so I can guide it down. And we don't have to do Ujjayi, strong, powerful core breath here when we breathe out, but it might be nice to try just watching full cycles of inhales where you're breathing in as much as you can without holding, and then exhaling fully and really allowing time for every bit of the exhale to go before you inhale again. Take a nice breath, breathing in through your spine. Follow the breath all the way up through your spine, through your neck, through the back of your head. And then press the ground away as you breathe out. Bring the torso up. You can set the block aside that's underneath your left leg. We'll let that go straight. And we're going to bend the right leg in again. So for this next twisting pose, you may want to sit up on something a little bit taller. If it becomes tricky, the right foot is going to go from the right side and hop over to the other side of the left leg. And we're going to keep the left leg straight for this variation. Coming into the twist, the left hand can hold the right shin, or maybe you go up and over with the left hand, the right thigh, and then the right hand will tent behind me. And we don't need to strenuously go into our deepest twist. We want to find a variation where we can breathe into where it feels relatively effortless, but still powerful. And sometimes that right balance of effort and ease changes as we progress in the pose. So keep your eye for openings where your body requests a slight more depth into the pose. And the opposite is true if you need to back off. So these twisting poses that we're doing, a certain sequence of them together is known as the colon cleanse. Very detoxifying and helping the body move along waste. Things physically in us that aren't serving us. And energetically, these twists are clearing as well. What have we been holding on to mentally that we need to let go of? An expectation for ourselves or others, or you know, the way things are going to happen. And there can be a sense of loss of that too, right? Loss of the idea. All right, we're slowly going to untwist. Extend the right leg out, both legs long, and give them a little kind of leg bounce where you bend one knee and then the other, just feeling the blood kind of go back in. And we're going to change our orientation and come back to hero's pose just for a moment. I'm going to go back to my kneeling surface and find my block here. So that I'm sitting upright in hero's pose, feeling good. Forward so that I have wing space. We're going to need space to move our arms up and out to the side. So what we'll do is we're going to reach our arms nice and wide with the palms facing up and just kind of glance left and glance right and see that your thumb and your pinky are about the same height from the ground. And then really spread your fingers as wide as you can. And then we're just going to rotate the palms down and back. And then back up. Right? So we're just rotating our hands in all directions, which is rotating our shoulder, possibly some joints in the arms, the wrists. All right. And then we're going to go ahead and give ourselves a hug where the right arm comes under the left. And you can hold opposite hand to opposite shoulder or take the full eagle bind. In this variation, my right palm is reaching around my left forearm and the right fingertips are reaching up towards the left palm. Now, as you inhale, really breathe into the back of the heart, breathe into the arms, let the elbows lift slightly. And then we're gonna just do a little rounding of the upper back. So no greater flexion of the hips. Don't lean forward with the torso. Just kind of sink the elbows, let the head go, and take some breath into the upper back. All the way in with the breath, all the way out with the breath. And then release, take the arms out nice and wide. Again, palms facing up. And go through that rotation of the hands, the arms, the shoulders, the wrists. And then the palms will face forward and we'll give ourselves a hug this time with the left arm under. And you can do the hug or take the bind where the left hand is reaching around the right forearm for the right palm. Breathing into the upper back, lift the elbows. And then we do the little upper back bend here. Really let the elbows drop towards the chest. Let the head drop. Full breath in. Full complete exhale out. One more time like that. And then we'll release. Now we're going to take the hands in a bind behind our back. You can interlace your fingers or you can use your strap and you would just hold a piece of the strap in the left hand and a piece of the strap in the right hand behind your back and have it be maybe shoulder width distance apart or closer depending on what the preference is. And then we're going to extend through the arms, breathe through the chest, little lift of the chin as you inhale. And then as we exhale, we're just going to tap our forehead down, maybe to the ground. Maybe it doesn't reach. That's okay. You could slightly lift your head, your hips to let your forehead touch down, but don't put any weight into your head. And the arms could lift from your sacrum. And you could stay or take another round of it where you lift up after you come up with breath and then go forward. Tap the head, lift the hips, and lift the hands. Eventually, we'll release our strap, release the bind. And now we have our second side to do for our little half Lord of the Fishes shoelace sequence here. We're going to have the left foot bent, and or the left knee bent, the foot to the ground, and hold on. Pop ourselves up, a little bit of rounding in the spine is okay, but not too much effort. Decide if we use that strap. Want it to go around your back and around the left leg and tighten it so that you don't have to work so hard. You can also just lean against something. Make sure the back of your hips are touching it if you're doing that. So really using our breath to clear the clutter inside the body, it creates a wind. It creates a vibration, which also helps things that are stuck loosen. And we'll take five more breaths on this side. And we'll start to set up for that half butterfly, where we allow the left knee to wing out to the side. Can support that if that doesn't feel comfortable, the knee dropping out. And I am gonna support the back of my right leg with a block, a little bit of bend there. My torso will angle towards my extended right leg. I'll flex at the hips and then flex the spine. My left hand can reach over for support and I can bow my head. Anytime you're not supported, the body or part of the body is just hanging, take a breath, breathe into it. Decide if it feels good or bad and you can go with your gut there. And if it's not great, build the props up to you. Tuck something in like a little blanket or a pillow so you create a little bit of ease. Then you can really stay in the pose to do that clearing breath work, which is where we get the benefit. And we'll start to come up, push the hands down. We've got one more on this side. My block can set aside. My left knee will come in. And I'll start to work on that twist. So lifting the seat up if you need be. Left foot steps to the other side of the right leg. My right hand can hold onto my left arm as I come into the twist. Or maybe the left arm goes up and over the right leg. And slowly work into the depth of the twist, especially up into the cervical spine. No need to jerk or force the neck with a lot of muscular engagement to look over the left shoulder just yet. Full breath in, full complete exhale out. Just keep refocusing to that cleansing breath. We'll slowly start to twist. Let the legs extend out and do the knee bounces one more time. You can even let the arms sweep down or the hands sweep down the legs to help the blood flow return. Right? Anytime we do these compression poses, whether it's the legs, the abdomen, any part of the body, we squeeze it out and it's very powerful when we release, everything opens up and new blood, new cells kind of come rushing in. We'll make our way to Hero's Pose one more time. Find my block to sit on. And we'll do a little side bending here. My right hand will come down to the ground and my right arm is straight. My right fingertips are tense. And I'm really activating that arm and keeping some space between my right ear and my right shoulder. And then I'm just going to gently inhale my left arm up. And then I'm going to bring my gaze to my left hand and let that left shoulder sneak back just a little bit and take a few rounds of breath here. And then we'll switch sides. The left hand can tend down. Left arm is straight and there's space between my left shoulder and ear. The right arm comes up. I gaze up and my right shoulder goes back just a pinch. And release. We're gonna set ourselves up for child's pose. So I'm gonna take this blanket that I'm kneeling on and unfold it a little bit more so that I can take my knees as wide as my mat. And then in this variation, we're gonna do a little side bending. I'm gonna sneak back just to be sure that you can see my hands in this pose. My knees come wide, my toes come together to touch. And as I walk and extend my arms out, I'm gonna bring both hands over to the right side of my mat. And they could just rest or you could grip the mat and then we'll want the head to rest down. So with all of the seated postures and the twisting that we did today, this widening child's pose might feel like a backbend to you. You might feel a little bit of freedom, more freedom in the front body. You could feel a little compression in the lower spine as it releases as the torso hangs. We'll take the arms back to center and then both hands over to the left. If your knees need a break from child's pose, you can take this pose laying on your front belly and just arcing over to the left. Where can you soften in the upper body? Maybe when you soften and you let go, you lose an inch of depth in the pose, or maybe more. But how does it feel in your body when you take that concession and you can breathe deeper into all the nooks and crannies of the arms and the shoulder? Right, and there's that letting go of perfection. Letting go of what we thought it should be or what we think it's prescribed to need to be. Finding the variation, finding the space, finding the breath. And from that space, props, you know, pops up creativity. opportunities. An ability to see things that we couldn't see before because we were straining. And it was clouding our awareness. All right, come back to center. As you come up through tabletop, move slowly. Don't put too much stress or weight into your arms as you come up. It might be a little bit sore feeling, that dull, achy feeling after we do a pose in yin means we were doing everything right. And when you're ready for transition, we're gonna move into some poses that we're gonna take on our back. And we're going to start with a supported fish. And so I'm going to put either a block or a thickly folded blanket way back to catch my head. And then I'm going to drape myself over the block going the wide way. And I'm going to go for the second highest height because I'm feeling like some depth would be nice. And you could try that on as far as kind of breaking open, welcoming spring. If it feels too intense though, just move the block on the lowest height. And then I'll come to sit down in front of it and might have to reach back to adjust as it come into the pose. They're never quite set up perfectly. And you want that first block to be hitting you at your shoulder blades, and you want your head to be dropping back so that there's a little bit of space in the front of your neck opening with your chin lifted slightly. But if it feels too strainful, just put something a little taller behind your head. And the legs are extended out straight. There's no need to hold the feet together. If the long leg variation is too much, you can take it with knees bent. And knees could either be over the ankles at hip width distance, or the knees could fall in for knee mat pose. And sometimes it's really hard to create that space, especially if there's uncertainty in our life or we're having to like currently work to something that hasn't come to fruition yet, or there still remains some questions or mystery. But even in that eye of the storm, we need to find that calm. We need to feel that space in the body and in the mind where we can let go and create that space, create that vibration and that release. And it can only put us in a better spot to, you know, make the decisions that we need to do. It can be very easy to get stuck in that trap of worry and thinking the same thought again and again and again. Just chewing it over is not necessarily productive. It's even counterproductive because it's filling up our energetic space. It's creating hormones in our body associated with those emotions, which aren't stabilizing, right? They're kind of destabilizing. And we're slowly going to make our way onto our back. So to come out of fish, it could be nice to roll to one side. And that way you roll off whatever prop was behind you. And then you can set it aside so that you can return to your back. If you had a prop underneath your head, you'll set that aside too. As you come to lay down, make sure that you have your strap and at least a block or a blanket handy for you. And we're gonna come into a wide knee twist. So I'm gonna, or sorry, wide feet and wide knee twist. So I'm gonna take my feet outer hip width distance, maybe even mat width distance. And then from here, both knees are gonna fall to the right. My legs are hovering here, and that doesn't necessarily put any intense sensations into my knees. So I could stay hovering, or I could take props and tuck them where there is space between the leg and the ground, like in between my outer right knee and the ground, and in between my inner left knee and my right leg. And then we'll take the right hand behind the head as we look left, and the left arm is out in that wing shape. And those thoughts will keep coming back in, keep coming back to your breath. Sometimes it's so tenacious, it's like the three-year-old who doesn't want to be in their toddler bed. You know, the mind just keeps coming back to whatever we're thinking every time we let it go, and we just meet that with compassion and say okay and do it again. Back to the breath, back to the clearing, back to the softening. And we'll come back to center with the knees. Move your props to the other side as the knees fall left. Make sure the feet are still wide apart. And the left hand could come behind the head. The gaze might then be more supported looking out over the right. And when you're breathing into the body and you're feeling the intensity of the sensation, know that that's a place in your body that you have stored away stress, right? That that's been a receptacle for probably a long time, either physically or energetically. And there's nothing bad or wrong. You know, we don't have a bad knee, we don't have a bad back, our backs are good, our knees are good. They've just been the bearer of a lot of of stress for a long time. And they just need our focus and attention in a really easeful way, not in a militant way. All right, and we'll come back to center with the knees, and you can extend the legs long. And from here, we're gonna come into a banana pose. So I'm gonna move myself over to the left, and then both my feet will step over to the right. You could scoot yourself further over to the left. If your legs are coming to the floor, you could pad them with a blanket, just so the ankles don't get too much pressure from the hard ground beneath them. And then see how it feels to cross the left leg over the right or the right leg over the left, and do whatever feels better. Make sure the left hip stays down and grounded. Again, not overdoing it. We don't want to forego this opening of the side bend for an extra perceived depth when the torso is leaning to the right and the left shoulder's coming up, the left hip's coming up, we're turning it into a twist opposed to a side bend. And so be mindful of that too as you bring the shoulder blades over to the right, but the left shoulder's staying down. And you could keep your arms in a bowl pose shape, you could do both hands behind the head, you could hold the right wrist, or sorry, the left wrist with the right hand. We're not in spring yet, but we're definitely making our way there. We're having these welcoming thoughts of, you know, newness is coming. We're letting go of the old. What's going to spring up in our life? And that kind of energy is related to the gallbladder line, which is the sideline body, the kind of meridian system. And for the last minute or so on this side, you could bring some more depth into the pose by going deeper into the arms. You could also bring the hands behind the head. And as the hands come by the head, you can kind of direct your twist with your elbow as your right elbow kind of reaches down more towards the top of your mat where your feet are, and your left elbow is kind of reaching up. You might be able to feel that side body stretch a little bit deeper, again, keeping the left shoulder and the left hip down. And then we'll slowly make our way back to center. And center is so important. It's almost energetically ceremonial and saying, you know, we're gonna create that time. We're not gonna just mindlessly rush into what I think is next in life and give a moment to feel the breath in our body, to feel a state of relaxedness and not rushing. And position yourself on the mat so that as you bring your feet over to the left, you have that padding for your heel, keeping the right shoulder down and the right hip down. Find the depth of the back, the side bend as we move the shoulders over to the left. Decide what variation will work for you now. And stay tuned into the body and the breath so that if the variation needed changes, we can feel those subtleties of the body. Before deciding, pause, listen, breathe. And then choose depth or softening or staying in the same variation for this last minute. And we come back to center. Find that neutral, restful breath. And we're going to set ourselves up for the next pose. You may have to roll to one side or come up to a seat so that you can adjust your props. We're gonna take a restorative pose. I think it's called a flowing river or flowing book. I don't remember, but here's the gist. We're gonna have something behind the heart that's really subtle. So if you have one of those small gorgeous balls, you could use that. Or what I really like to do is just fold up and then roll a blanket so it's kind of wide enough to span the back, but not so high that it creates a great depth. And then we're gonna either use blocks or the bolster to go behind the knees. So if you use blocks, you'll use one block kind of just underneath the lower part of the back of the thigh. And if you're using your bolster, you'll put that behind your knees. If you're short like me and your feet come up, you could put something underneath them as well, unless the hovering feels okay. Okay, so as we have this really subtle prop behind our shoulder blades, you wanna feel that your arms are completely rested well to the ground. So you may have to scoot yourself back a little bit more to get that feeling. And then certainly put something underneath the head, a thin, very flat pillow or blanket could work. And then just let the arms rest in any shape that feels okay. And I want you to focus intensely on the inhales and the exhales for the next several cycles of breath, say five or so. And really feel I'm breathing in all I need to breathe in. I'm not rushing to the next breath. I'm not holding. And then I'm breathing out, giving time for all the exhale to leave, but not holding. And follow that through the next few more cycles of breath. And this energetically says, I'm open. I'm here. I'm ready, I'm present, but I'm not rushing. I'm waiting, I'm choosy. Right, whatever the future brings, whatever's coming tomorrow, what's ever coming the next minute, I'm easeful and ready. And we'll slowly bring some movement back into the fingers, toes, spread them, close them, make circles with the ankles and the wrists in both directions. And then please take your time thoughtfully, slowly set props aside, do anything that you need to do to come up to a seat. I like coming to fetal shape. It's another one of those kind of ceremonious poses in yoga that just reminds us each freaking moment, we can choose again. It does not matter. We messed up the last moment. Here we are today, starting again with that presence. And as you come upright, breathe into your spine. And just notice the space you created in your body and your mind. And we'll bring hands to heart center, Anjali Mudra, with gratitude for all that we have. And breathe in. Breathe out. And namaste. Thank you very much for being here, for joining me. Let me know if you have questions at all. And I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Take care.